they asked the staff there if this is where the terrorists are meeting.
Some members of the North Texas Muslim community say they are worried after at least two situations that made them feel threatened where they normally feel safe. Hi and good evening. I'm Steve Eager. First on Fox 4 News at 5:30 tonight, the Center for American-Islamic Relations in Dallas, also known as CAIR-DFW, is concerned after two acts of intimidation it believes are linked to the election of Donald Trump. The president-elect addressed other similar situations during an interview on CBS's 60 Minutes last night.
I'm very surprised to hear that. I hate to hear that. I mean, I hate
but
to hear
it. But you do hear it.
I don't hear it. I saw one or two instances.
On social media?
I think
media?
It's a very small amount. Again, I think it's
do
the media.
Do you want to say anything to those people?
I would say don't do it. That's terrible. Because I'm going to bring this country together.
They're harassing Latinos, Muslims.
I am so saddened to hear that. And I say stop it. If it helps, I will say this, and I'll say it right to the camera, stop it.
But CAIR thinks Trump isn't doing enough. Fox 4's Alex Boyer in Dallas with the story. Alex.
Well, Steve, I can tell you that CAIR's executive director, Ali Asalem, equates what Trump said to what a parent might say to a six-year-old child who's throwing food across the table at their younger sibling, basically saying, stop it. She calls that just a slap on the wrist. She tells me in just the past 24-hour period, I should say, that members of the Muslim community in Dallas have been the target of harassment and intimidation.
It had just been a really long and exhausting week.
It started on Friday with a frightening incident outside the office of the Center for American-Islamic Relations in Dallas while staffers were working inside.
People on motorcycles and pickup trucks waving flags and wearing masks and flipping off our building and shouting expletives at our, location. And it, is just an unnerving situation.
CAIR-DFW Executive Director Ali Asalem says the group also displayed the logo for Three Percenters, a self-described patriot movement which pledges resistance against any restriction of the U.S. Constitution.
It's the hatred that has been unleashed that really is scaring people.
Just one day after reporting the incident to Dallas police, she says members of the Muslim community were targeted again, this time at a venue described as a sanctuary. A community coffee shop in Dallas.
It was intimidating and shocking.
Pastor Mike Bachman is the community curator at Union Coffee, a nonprofit sponsored by the United Methodist Church. Saturday afternoon, CAIR-DFW was holding a meeting there on race relations when a barista at the coffee shop got a startling phone call.
They asked the staff there if this is where the terrorists are meeting.
About 20 Muslim Americans were inside at the time of the call. The barista hung up, called 911, then called Pastor Mike, who took immediate action.
Got the word out to a couple of our people who are a part of our congregation and asked them if they would come out and just provide hospitality to the folks who are here from the event so that they would know that they're welcome here, that we want them here.
Members of United Methodist sat with Muslim Americans until the event was over. A kind gesture Salem will never forget.
When Pastor Mike asked me how I was doing, I just broke down in tears.
And Salem says private security hired by them did escort the Muslim Americans who were attending the event to their cars after the event was over, simply as a safety precaution. She tells me that they were worried the person who called may show up to the event and take more drastic action in person because of the fact that the information for that race relations discussion was posted online. Steve?
Alex, talk a little bit more about that. The church, the pastor, the coffee shop, are they going to do anything in the future, do anything differently?
I asked him that, and he says no, Steve. He tells me that one of their core values at the Union Coffee Shop is to provide a safe place for people in the community like CAIR-DFW who sometimes, may struggle to find a place to meet. Pastor Mike tells me the staff, he feels, handled the incident appropriately, calling 911 and then informing him immediately. I asked Pastor Mike if he would have CAIR back to the venue in the future, and he tells me absolutely 100%.